I did it again. I muted it again. How's everybody doing? This is the flagship show. I'm glad you guys are here. Welcome to the show. Is volume working now, chat? All right. Welcome to the flagship. Thanks, everybody, for coming. This is episode 2. We're going to have a lot of fun. Everybody was talking about last week's show. People were coming up to me on the street saying thank you. Thank you for doing this. So it was really cool. And I got it. I just finished doing the last day of recording for the Whitest Kids movie. We just finished it about an hour ago. That's why I'm kind of a little flustered here. So we're excited about that. We got a lot of stuff to get to tonight. But again, relax, enjoy the show. This is going to be, this show is to be, I said this last week, but this show is supposed to help people. I think of this show, this is what I said last week, like a god of old outstretching his arms to the cowering masses of mortals and saying lovingly, I am with you. That's what this show is. So thank you everybody for coming. We're going to start. I'm going to just go ahead and jump right into this. I'm going to bring up my first guest. My first guest here. Again, I'm learning OBS. And by the way, I think I'm doing a pretty damn good job besides the muting problems I have. Here we go. My first guest tonight, you may know him from Screen Junkies or many other things. Hal Rudnick. How are you? Oh, Hal Rudnick and Millie the dog. So, you're mute. You're mute. Chat says you're mute. Hold on. All right, hold on. I'll figure it out. What about this? Hold on. Talk now. Hold on. Nope, that's no good. Still muted. All right. We'll figure it out. All right, so let me see. Let me go. I'm going to try. No, because I'm hearing you fine. So let me try some things real quick. Let me undo this. Let me change. All right, so I got that. Hold on, guys. This is stunt flying. I'm going to figure it out. So I'm going to make some changes here. What about now?
Can you hear me?
Hey!
Yeah.
Okay.
Now?
I can hear you now.
Is it happening?
Yeah. All right. See? Look at that.
Hey,
that
chat,
was that
can
was.
You hear me? Can you hear me, chat? Yes.
We did it.
What a glorious day.
I know.
Oh, Trevor, I'm so glad we're able to do this. Thank you for having me. I'll see you next time. Bye, everybody.
So now they're saying, now chat is saying right channel only.
What now?
Yeah, they're saying it's in mono. Hold on, let me figure this out. Let me see.
No, I don't have mono.
Let me see. All right, mix, audio, da-da-da. Audio input capture. Yeah, I don't know. I don't know how to fix that. Let me see. Let's see if you're coming.
Maybe Chad's headphones are broken. Hey, Chad, it's time to get some new earbuds, my dude.
Well, chat, is this okay? Can we hear? Can we hear enough? People are saying sounds good to me. All of our headphones are broken. Okay, people are saying yes. So I'm gonna do this for right now. Maybe I'll work on it and I'll try to fix it a little down the road. But welcome to the show, Hal. How have you been?
Oh, it's great to see you. You know what? I've been I've been relatively pretty good. No corona. Just hanging out with the dogs and my wife. Good times.
So you never got corona?
Well, I might have had it, but I didn't get tested. But about a year ago, last March, I made the bonehead move of going to Universal Studios.
Oh.
And right before a shutdown happened, and that's a petri dish right there.
And did you get sick after that?
Yes, I felt like my throat swelled up for a week, and I was super fatigued, and. I might have been an early adopter of the corona, the light edition. Like it didn't destroy me.
Yeah.
But like I felt like I had something, and it was right when corona was happening. So I don't know. Just adds up to me. But I often misdiagnose myself and go down WebMD rabbit holes. So.
Right. I had coronavirus, and it wasn't that bad. Like I had.
Well, that's good to hear. You and your whole family had it, right?
Whole family got us. It worked through the whole family like a plague, and but nobody had it bad. It wasn't that bad.
You'd recommend it?
It was. I mean, I've said this before on here. What I did was I filled up my car with tequila and pot, and I just drove up to the beach, and I just I did a last stand thing where I was like, well, either I'm gonna die, so this will be my last week, or I'll live, and I'll be like, I beat it this way. That was my thinking, and the latter happened. So, but I've talked about that before. I want to talk about you, Hal Rudnick, Halford Rudnick.
Yes.
Is that your first name, Halford?
It's actually Halliburton.
Halliburton. Oh, wow.
Yeah. Yeah. My parents let Dick Cheney name me.
Oh, that's nice.
Yeah. And,
huge Republicans, your parents. Huge Republican donors.
Huge Republicans. Major donors to the party. We're talking just below Koch brother level donors.
Now, so corona, it's over now, right? That's what everybody's saying. Like, is that Dr. Fauci's like, it's done. Everybody can go back to doing whatever.
Okay, for real, you know, I'm not out here playing fast and loose. Listen, mm-hmm. I'm not hugging. I'm not going back to the hugging yet.
Mm-hmm. No? Do you think you ever will?
Maybe I'm going to become a more judicious hugger.
I had a party here a couple weeks ago, mm-hmm. and I only invited vaccinated people, and it was weird. People were standoffish, like because nobody's hugged, nobody's. And I always try to kiss all my guests mm-hmm. at some point in the
That's
evening.
That's gotten you in trouble before.
A lot of times. Or you at least try to kiss the ladies, you know. It's just gentlemanly, right?
Yeah, I've always admired that understanding that you and your wife
have. but yeah, like...
What about that Thomas Middleditch open relationship?
Whoa. the old Thomas Middleditch. Goth sex nightclub thing.
Did you hear about his Playboy interview?
Oh yeah. I'm obsessed. You know Thomas. He's around. Like you know.
Yeah.
He's a guy in the comedy community, and I.
Sure.
I don't know. I'm. You know. I wish no ill will for the guy, but I'm fascinated with that. Like you know.
Yeah.
I feel like. Well, also, if he's creeping people out, maybe I do wish ill will for him. You know. Like that's not good. You can't be doing that. You can't be going around.
Yeah, but I mean, at least stop creeping people out.
Yeah. Yeah.
I tried to stop creeping people out a while back.
Well, you talked with him. I remember you sat Thomas down and had a big talk with him. But you were like, you got to stop doing this.
Yeah. I sat him down on my knee. And I'm like, I rubbed the small of his back. And then I realized, wow, I'm asking him to creep people out, but I am actually creeping him out. So then I've been doing a lot of soul searching over the course of the whole pandemic.
Someone's saying, this guy looks familiar. Who is he? All right, we'll go into that. And people are, I mean, I'm sorry. I'm looking at the chat. I am going to read donos tonight, by the way. I figured out how to do it. So we are going to read donations. But also, I don't really know... I mean, I can try to figure out what's wrong with the audio right now, but I feel like that would be dead air. like if I just kind of stop and try to mess around with the settings. So I don't know. They say Sam's going to do it. I hope so. I don't know. If somebody can do it, that would be great. But I don't know. I don't know how, or if someone could shoot me a text about how to do it. But, you know, some people are saying it's better if you take the headphones off. So if you can take the headphones off, maybe it'll be fine.
I'm not wearing headphones.
It sounds fine to me, but it's not going through, you know, the thing. So this show is a work in progress. Look, we got a graphic now. Last week I didn't have a graphic. So a nice, I think the fan's name is Future Reunion Tour that made that graphic. And so it's getting a little better. It's getting a little polished, a little more polished every time.
I love it. The LA is prominent, and that's where we're both situated right now.
Both live in LA. Yep. Yes. Now, okay, so we should go. You're Screen Junkies. Would that be where most people know you from?
Yeah, probably. That's that was a fun run there. Hosted there a bunch. Had a lot of videos people watched for sure.
Yeah. Hundreds of millions of how many subscribers did you have at the peak of that?
Dozens.
But
six and a half, 7 million.
Wow, that's great. Yeah. You're an influencer basically.
Oh yeah, a YouTube influencer. I was very much on the older end of YouTube influencers.
Yeah.
If I got any bigger as an influencer, I would be boxing Logan Paul.
Yeah, that's are you into that? I'm obsessed with that. He's going to fight.
Did you see Jake Paul steal Floyd Mayweather's hat the other day?
Yep, saw that. Loved it.
Oh yeah, that was some insane shit. I mean, but like, it's just, in that world, it's piece of shits colliding, you know?
Yeah.
A Floyd Mayweather, a fucking spousal abuser, against another kind of abuser.
It
was just like, just shit colliding with shit.
Yeah, I think boxing has always been kind of that, a bunch of spousal abusers fighting other spousal abusers. Somebody says, so also we get real mean comments here. Don't take it personal. Everybody gets mean comments.
Oh, yeah. What'd they say?
Ugh, this guy reminds me of too much of a dude I hooked up with, and the dick was mediocre.
You know, here's the thing. I don't mind reminding you the guy, but, like, if you check out the equipment, maybe it turns out I got that good dick.
So I remember the thing that was crazy to me about Screen Junkies, I'm going to jump back to Screen Junkies, was that you had a show before the Oscars. Screen Junkies got so big, I was eating in a burger diner, and then they were showing, you had like a pre-Oscar show.
Mm-hmm.
How that was that? That's pretty crazy.
Yeah, we had a pre-Oscar show. It started, it grew, and then, then it changed management and a few different things, and they started hemorrhaging money and stuff like that. But we had a lot of fun, and they sent me all sorts of places, like doing that job. They sent me to Japan. They sent me to Paris.
Oh, wow.
I had lots of fun just talking movies, talking streaming. But even though I got paid to talk a lot about movies, I still haven't seen – I hate to tell you this.
What?
I still haven't seen either of the Paddington movies, Trey.
Oh my God, you gotta watch them. They're fantastic. You can watch number two without number one. Have you seen?
Really?
But talking about movies, have you seen the new Roland Emmerich trailer that came out today?
No. What's the movie?
I love Roland Emmerich. You know.
Oh yeah.
Independence Day. All those movies where it's like the whole world's in trouble, but he just did one that's fucking insane. Like, I just think it's crazy. I'll see if I can pull it up and show it.
Sure.
You'll have to watch it through the stream, though. But
okay.
Here.
Yeah, I got the stream up over here. And I got to tell you, a very bad experience and association I have with Paddington Bear.
Oh, okay. All right. I don't know if I'm going to like that story, but here we go. All right.
Okay.
Okay, here we go. So this is the new Roland Emmerich movie that just came out today, and I think this is just, I don't know, I think it's going a little. This is good. Let's see what you think. This is going a little nuts, I think. But
School of French Kissing for Dogs, shout out.
Right?
You know, I'll give it to him that it's topical because, like, I mean, there were definitely times when it felt like this is what was going to happen in 2020. But, yeah, I think he went, I think it's a bridge too far, quite frankly.
Yeah, kind of nuts.
And right? I don't know. Well, first off, I love seeing some of my favorite filmmaking studios. I love Marvel Studios. Big A24 fan. I'm a Midsummer and an Uncut Gems kind of guy. But like, I don't know why they banked this horse. I don't know why they staked their claim on. Yeah.
Yeah, it was weird. It was weird to me that it was weird to me that A24 and Marvel were teaming up.
Yeah,
and then they got New Line Cinema, which I think is done. I think they've been out of business for 20 years.
Oh,
yeah,
weird. And, I mean, maybe it's a comeback
just because some people are like, "What the fuck?" No, I it's a fake trailer. I edited it.
Pretty good.
Did I trick you? Did you think it was real for a couple seconds?
When you told me there was a new Roland Emmerich film, I was like, oh wow. But then when I saw A24 and Marvel, I'm like, okay, let's see what these shenanigans are.
So you got it there.
Pretty much, because A24 and Marvel are the opposite ends of the spectrum.
I felt really weird when I was making that because there was one point where I was like, oh, whites. And I was like, blacks? I guess that is that. It feels weird to write that. That seems messed up.
Yeah, maybe BIPOCs, POC.
I don't know. I know I did Latinx, right? But also, like, I didn't want to put, like, African-Americans because that just sounds super racist. Like, that all just sounds like somebody who's, like, doesn't know any black people, kind of.
You know what? Let's put that aside and talk more about you sticking the landing with the Latinx. That was the best racially motivated piece of comedy I've seen since the Dave Chappelle racial draft sketch.
Oh, yeah. Remember when Kramer said all that stuff?
I was walking down Sunset past the Laugh Factory, and the TMZ tour bus, Hollywood tour bus, drove by, and they drove by the Laugh Factory, and they said, "This is where Michael Richards from Seinfeld disgraced himself."
Oh, no, really? That's part of the tour now?
Yeah. Oh, TMZ has a Trevor. Let's take the TMZ tour sometime.
I would love to. That would be great.
Yeah. Let's get liquored up and take the TMZ tour.
I would love to do that. I just remember when Kramer did all that, like, you know, and you know, you can't come back from that. The fact that, like, you know, but he went on, Jerry Seinfeld was on Letterman, remember?
Yeah.
And then he was like, my friend, this is like the week afterwards, he's like, I want my friend to come on and say I'm sorry. And then Kramer comes on and he says, I want to apologize to Afro-Americans. You remember that?
Wow.
Like he even screwed that up. Like he's like, I want to apologize to all the Afro-Americans. And then And then everybody starts laughing because they don't know what to do. And then Jerry Seinfeld chastises the audience. Like, he's like, guys, this isn't funny. And it's like,
a serious moment. I remember that.
And it's like, no, it's very funny. This guy has no idea what he's doing. He just said,
he's digging the hole deeper and deeper. And he also had just some awkward mea culpa on the comedians in cars getting coffee.
Oh, he did?
Yeah.
Well, what do you say about that? Like, I remember he's like, that wasn't me.
Yeah.
That wasn't me. That's like, he literally took like the Shaggy defense.
Yeah. Like, it wasn't me. that's tough. I mean, but it's weird that there are different levels. Like Bill Maher said it.
He
was able to come back. Yeah, I guess it's context and everything. Yeah, Kramer's was like an awkward grasp.
His was just angry and hateful. Like, you know, you could tell he just kind of snapped, like somebody was heckling him. And so then he was saying it out of rage. And so you're like, oh, wow, there's like, you know, there's like a real fucked up dude underneath there. It's like you know, when Liam Neeson last year was doing that.
Oh, yeah, he was like, he said, my friend got raped and I wanted to kill the first black bastard I came across.
Yeah, that.
And I'm like, whoa.
Yeah.
You know what? You could have kept that memory in the vault. You did not, like, you know, like you tweet, nobody, then Liam Neeson, I wanted to kill the first black bastard. Oh my God.
Well, I just love that it was like, you know, like, he's not, I mean, he's promoting some sort of silly film. And so there's some guy who wrote it and some guy who directed it and a whole team of people who spent years on this thing.
Well,
and
then they find. Let's clarify it. If it's Liam Neeson, it's an old guy getting revenge.
True. But they work on this movie and it's about to come out. It's like opening week. And then, like, Liam Neeson's like, I got a funny chestnut. This is what I'll talk about on my press tour.
You know what the best opening week moment was? When Louis C.K. got outed right before his black and white movie was to come out.
Oh, right.
Where there was a scene about him describing jerking off in front of someone in the movie.
Oh, really?
Yes.
That's weird. Like, if you know, because here's the thing. Everybody knew that about him.
Yeah, it was like the unspoken comedy secret.
Yeah, it was a big deal when it happened at the comedy festival. People were like, "This fucked up thing happened," you know.
Oh, was it? Were you? Was it when you guys were at? What was that, Aspen?
I don't know, but I heard about it around that time, and so everyone knew about it, like kind of thing.
Wait, did he do it to you and Sam?
No.
Oh, okay.
But like everyone knew, so like if everyone knew that this kind of fucked up thing happened. You know, like, you know that people know and are talking about it. Why would you write a movie about that? Like, why would you do scenes about that in like a
thing? He was doing his whole Woody Allen take. You know, I mean, if you go like Woody Allen, you know, he married this young woman who was his fucking daughter. His movie Manhattan. He's dating a high school girl, like it's not a big deal.
Right. Maybe they're trying to normalize it.
Maybe, or maybe it's a secret, like, plea for help or something. It's like, you know, please cancel me. This is the bad thing I'm doing. Yeah. I don't know.
Root Beer Pope says, well, he got you talking about it, didn't he? So I guess he's right. It was a completely successful PR move.
Yep.
It
worked. Trevor, you know, real quick, because it's such a good story. I don't know if it's a good story, but my Paddington quip. I used to, when I first moved to LA, I would do kids' birthday parties. I was an entertainer at kids' birthday parties. And one of the worst experiences I ever had was playing Paddington Bear. First off, this was before the movies. So what fucking, like, a sullen child wants Paddington at their party.
Well, I'll be honest. When I was a kid, Paddington was my absolute favorite character. I was obsessed with him because I grew up on a bus and I lived in hotels all the time. Mm-hmm. So Paddington's whole thing in the books was that he was like trying to find a home, and he was like staying at a lot of hotels and stuff like that. So I liked Paddington.
Well, that's a lovely story.
Thank you.
You know what? I feel shame for what I just said about Paddington.
No, but here's the truth. I was a very melancholy child. So that it kind of tracks with what you're saying.
Well, it served you. So I was playing Paddington, and the reason why it was horrific is because not only did I have to wear a fur bear suit, which was like carpet, I had to wear a wool overcoat, the blue overcoat over the fur bear suit, and the party was in the San Fernando Valley in August. So I think I died for a moment and got resuscitated in the middle of that party.
You got like heat stroke?
It was hell level sweats. So that's my Paddington nightmare experience.
Yeah, that's horrible.
And having to be like, oh, diddle, hey, everybody, you know, be upbeat. I also, one other birthday party, kid's birthday party story. I once had a massive panic attack during a kid's birthday party. And yeah.
That makes sense.
Yeah.
Like, I bet that happens all the time. Like, I had, hold on, my dog, I let my dog out and I forgot to let her back in. Hold on. This is going to be 10, will you vamp for 10 seconds while I let my dog in?
Absolutely. You know, this is Millie the dog. Talk with her for a moment. Well, one of my favorite things to do when I was doing kids' birthday parties was, I liked being a clown. Because a clown has no rules. A clown is a lawless motherfucker. When I was a clown at kids' birthday parties, I would steal people's hats. I would be a real wise ass. And it's like, oh, well, what am I supposed to do? I'm a clown.
Yeah. John Wayne Gacy was a clown.
Yes. I mean, one of many things I have in common with John Wayne Gacy.
You know, I do a Disney show, which you've been on and you've written on.
I was
directing an episode, and it was my birthday, and my mother, she didn't know what to get me. So what she did was she hired a singing telegram to send it to set while I was directing, which is like, that's not when you're directing, you're just trying to make sure that you're making your day. You're like, we have 5 minutes to finish this scene. Then we have to put this, to do this setup, all this stuff. So like, I don't want to stop for a singing telegram guy. And I could just see when he came in and saw that he was going to a set, because I think a lot of the people who do the singing telegram, especially in Los Angeles, are aspiring actors. You know,
totally.
They want to do acting. And so, like, you could tell that he was like, oh, I don't want to do this in the middle of, like, a set, like, you know, kind of thing. Like, and so he was kind of like this, and then I was like this, because, like, oh, I don't want you to do this. Like, I don't know why my mom did this to me. Like, I have to. And you could tell he was just going through, like, it's your birthday, like that. And then, like, he just kind of walked out to his car and put all of his, he came in as a wrestler and put all his wrestler clothes. It was very depressing.
Did he have the physique of a wrestler?
No. And he had stayed around a little long. Like, you know, you could tell, like, he was a little past, like, maybe he thought he'd be doing it for 10 years, but now it's like looking at 20 kind of thing.
Oh, I thought you meant he stayed around a little long, on the set of the show. And I was going to say, he probably wanted some of that crafty.
Yeah.
One time I got called to do a clown birthday party, and it ended up being a bunch of adults who wanted a party
to fuck a clown.
A gag. Yeah, who wanted to fuck a clown, and I ended up tied up in a warehouse. And it was at the party were a bunch of people I went to film school with, and I was so embarrassed.
Oh, that's horrible.
Yeah, it was like a scene out of like a Paul Thomas Anderson movie or something. And it was very awkward, but they were very nice about it. But yeah, also your mom getting you the singing telegram reminded me, when I turned 21, I was at college, and my dad came to visit me, and he wanted to hire a stripper. just for me, him, and a buddy of mine.
Oh.
And
so it's like a real cool dad.
Too cool. That sounded like the worst thing in the world to me. Yeah. And I was like, please do not. Please, please, please do not, dad.
Yeah, it's like, and, hey, son, do you you want to get a boner with me and my buddy?
Yeah. What if we got hard together?
Oh, that's super awkward.
Although, if he offered to do that at my bar mitzvah, then I would have. If he did it for 13-year-old Hal.
I'm getting... Okay, guest is too quiet. I know. We don't know what to do about it.
Is it my volume? Huh.
That sounds pretty good. I don't know. So some people are saying... So we got some comments here. We're going to read Donos in a second. Someone says, clowns are in whiteface. So racist.
I feel like you have Caucasian, if that's a thing even anymore. Mm-hmm. And then clown white. Clown white is different from skin. All right? Unless you're saying clown is a race. Do we have to acknowledge the clown race now?
Well, I think actually... I could be wrong about this, but what I've heard is that the classic clown, the clown that we all know and love or hate, you know,
like Bozo, Emmett Kelly.
Yeah, it was an old stereotype of the Irish.
Huh.
That's why it had the red nose. It was that gin blossom nose. They had this super pale skin. They always had red hair. And they wore patchwork clothes because the Irish were seen as very poor. And that was also the gag of like, cause the Irish were also like made fun of for having so many kids. That was the gag of all the clowns coming out of the car. Like the car door opens and all of the clowns coming out. So
wow.
I think it's a holdover from the old Irish need not apply kind of thing. Like,
you're shining some light on some of history's most despicable acts.
There you go. Cover. Yeah. That's why everybody hates clowns, because everybody hates the Irish.
There it is. You know, I mean, I just wish the Irish could get a fair shake in this country.
I want to help out. I'm going to read Donos in a second, but I want to, if you want to know who Hal is, Hal... probably one of my first friends in L.A. Probably you, James Adomian, Josh Fadum, and Hal was in a lot of my early music videos. I think I have a picture right here. There we go. Hal was in the Pope rap video.
Yes.
Hal was the one of the fellow popes or priests who was blinging it out with the Pope. And then also, Hal was also in the Founding Fathers video. He played the king.
Oh,
you can say the king there talking on one of those tin can phones.
Yeah, a pretty Semitic looking king, but king nonetheless.
Well, we also, I think,
like King David, the king of Israel.
Yeah, and then in my Help Me video, Hal played Bar Mitzvah Dad.
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
Yes.
So there. Those are that is Hal. In a lot of our
awesome
things.
Stuff. Thanks for pulling those.
Oh, no problem. Yeah, look at all the work I did. Excited. I've actually pulled some other things too, because I've seen a bunch of people talking in here about Midnight Show.
Oh yeah.
Fantastic sketch group that Hal was a part of. Integral part of.
Yeah, everybody, they're coming up with my IMDb here. That RoboCop thing, too full for too cool.
Well, that's also, you and I were both in the same scene for the RoboCop thing.
Oh, were we?
Yeah, because I was the guy behind the counter, and you were the guy robbing the place. And also,
oh, yeah, with John Morrison.
Yeah, and also when I did my Comedy Central, one of my Comedy Central things where I did stand up, and I was talking about how I got stuck in Mexico, a buddy of mine, and I went down and got stuck in Mexico. You were the buddy. It was you and me that got stuck in Mexico in that horrible story.
Oh, that was unbelievable. I thought we were never going to get out of there because we drove down there, walked across, and then we got in the car, and then we almost went back across the border when we were.
I jumped out of the car and had to talk to everybody, and they were pissed at us.
Yeah, we had to make a U-turn in the middle of like the freeway that heads into Mexico.
Yeah. Yeah, because we were trying to get back to
traffic.
We were trying to get back to Eric Andre's party, and we didn't want to miss it, and so we shut down the whole border of Mexico. So basically, you and I are like Laurel and Hardy. We have such a storied history together of all of our
many wacky misadventures.
Yeah, we've been.
And next, you and I are going to get faded, and then take the TMZ tour bus.
It's the fun never stops. Someone says, name drops Eric Andre. Yeah, I guess that was, wasn't it? Because I said we're going to go to Eric Andre's party. He's not interested.
But you're a pal of Eric Andre.
I know.
Vacation
I know, but I think that does count as a name drop because he's not important to that story. Like, I just said it because I was, like, kind of stream of consciousness, but now I feel bad because, it is sort of, that was a name drop. I agree, so.
You know what? So you don't feel as bad, I'll name drop, okay?
Please do, because I feel like a douchebag.
I don't know if there are any Pokemon fans out there, but back when I was doing kids' birthday parties 20 years ago, I played Pikachu in the big yellow outfit and did a birthday party for the child of, wait for it, conservative commentator, former host of Weekend Update, Dennis Miller.
Oh, how's the kid? I thought you were going to go Victoria Jackson until you said Weekend Update.
Dennis Miller, he was actually a pretty nice dude. He invited me to come take my big Pikachu head off and cool off in his refrigerated wine closet.
Oh, that's nice.
Yeah.
I like that.
Oh, but I'll tell, here's a little Hollywood inside poop.
Oh, good. Let's just do our own TMZ tonight.
Sure. Dennis Miller, not a great tipper, wasn't a great tipper. Palatial home in, Santa Barbara, not a good tipper.
Hmm.
Interesting. One more piece of Hollywood dish at that same party. Wait for it. Hollywood handsome boy, bad boy, star of a sex tape in the 80s or 90s, Rob Lowe.
Oh, now I've heard good tipper.
Rob Lowe, you know what? Haven't had the pleasure of getting tipped by Rob.
Yeah, I'm trying to think. What's good dirt on people?
Oh, here's some real dirt.
Yeah, how can we start trending on Twitter?
Oh, like drop some like real bombshells?
Yeah. Oh, I got one.
Yeah.
It's not. So, Zendaya.
Yes.
Was a guest on one of my shows.
I remember back when I was working on it, in talks to have Zendaya. She was on the tail end of her Disney days.
Yeah. And I don't think that she really wanted to be there.
Oh! Wow. That's,
it was almost as if it was a PR thing.
You're telling me Zendaya's guest spot on another Disney Channel show, she might have just been going through the motions?
You mean an A-list movie star might not have...
you know what? I'm going to look at Zendaya very differently now.
No, the whole time I was kind of like, I get it, Thank you for doing it.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, I got another thing. This is your life. If there are any people who are out there who are not are thrilled that Hal is on the show yet. I don't think there's many of them because, this has been delightful. We've told
having fun here.
Yeah, we told of our stories together. But I'm going to show you, I pulled something that might be one of my favorite things you've ever done.
Oh.
And before you watch this, I would also like to point out that I went to your wedding. It was one of the last things that I did in the pre-COVID world, you know?
Yes.
You had a wedding right towards the end. And I went there and I was very starstruck at your wedding because the guy from Chernobyl was there.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Jared Harris.
Yeah. I was like, and I was sitting sort of close. Then I was like, and the whole time I just stared at him. I was like, because I love that show. I was like, that's the guy. Yeah. That's the guy who knows about all the radiation when no one else knows about it yet. Because that's where I was. That's where I was in the thing. But I was like, he knows and nobody else knows how bad it is. But he knows.
Jared and his wife Allegra are friends of ours, and real nice guy.
Yeah.
I once did a comedy show that he was at, and you know that character? Do you remember that character I did, Eric Jennifer?
Oh yeah. Well, yeah, hold on. I'm gonna show a clip.
Okay.
Oh, go ahead. Yeah.
But anyway, I did the character, and afterwards I got off the stage, and esteemed actor, son of a knight, Sir Richard Harris.
Okay. Like him a little less.
Yeah. I mean, you don't like those ties to the matriarchy.
I am Irish. Like I'm sort of in the blow up everyone with a title camp.
Oh yeah. You know what? I didn't mean to offend your politics. But he said to me, very good job. Very, very good. Very funny.
Oh, that's good.
I was like, oh, you know what? That'll get me through the next few months, that word of praise from Jared Harris.
Very good job. Very good. He's like, I was going to try one, but I'm not good at impressions. Like, I was going, oh, very. Did you know about the radiation in Chernobyl? See, what I don't know what I'm doing.
That was pretty good.
Yeah, yeah, pretty good. Yeah. All my impressions sound like Ali G or Borat, one of those two. All right, so I'm gonna show. This is one of my favorite clips, probably of any sketch show. But this is a Hal Rudnick, and I believe is a Hal Rudnick Heather Campbell joint. That's I could be wrong, but that's what I believe. And the weird thing about this was that you actually played this at your wedding. And I remember being like, oh, wow, that's I've never seen this before. So this, take a look at this. I love this. Here we go.
I'm Alan Herman, and let's get right to it. I'm president of the school that will teach your dog how to French kiss. At Herman's School of French Kissing for Dogs. At Herman's Dog French Kissing School, your dog will walk in a mutt and walk out a man. We're talking full mouth, full tongue, full dog kissing classes with seminars like...
The Stash Tickler, the Gentleman, the Full Schnauzer, and the Gutter Perver.
Some of you maybe say, my dog can already French. I've never heard anything more wrong in my life. Your dog is licking. A kiss takes time and penetration. What makes me an expert? I've kissed men of all ages. Now I can give your dog my years of expertise.
So why am I being so generous? I won the lottery, so I could do whatever I want. That's why I bought out Arby's. But you know that from my other commercials. So fuck the haters. I want to teach your dog to kiss like a person with dignity and respect and none of that all over the place dog bullshit they always pull. I've talked to the police and they say it's cool. So enroll your dog in Herman's School of French Kissing for Dogs and then fucking get in there. Come here.
Yeah.
much.
That's pretty great. That's pretty great.
Yep. Yeah, written by Heather Ann Campbell. Man, that was fun.
That's what sketch comedy's supposed to be. Just a bunch of guys kissing dogs.
Yeah, fucking going for it, my guy. Going for it.
I love the thing that always made me laugh about that is the backstory about how he won the lottery and he bought Arby's and I could watch a movie about that guy, like just some idiot who wins the lottery and is just like fuck it, fuck everything, I'm gonna do exactly what.
We did a sequel where I played Alan Herman at Arby's and in the live show. And I brought out like a bucket of roast beef and a bucket of tartar sauce. And like Heather and Sloniker had to get on their knees and eat roast, like loose roast beef and tartar sauce out of buckets. yeah.
Fun That's, fact. I remember, so there used to be a thing called the most offensive or the most fucked up sketch show.
Oh, yeah. Dirtiest sketch show.
Dirtiest sketch show. Yeah. And me and a couple of the guys from Midnight Show there used to be this house that you guys all lived at. And I don't think you actually lived there.
Yeah, I didn't, but I spent more than enough time there.
Yeah, but this was called the Midnight House.
And yeah, it was like a giant frat house for like really for comedians with bad hygiene.
Yeah. And there's I've run across two of these houses in my life. One was called Apple Soda, and it was just a bunch of people who were living in a storefront in New York that the only thing you could tell from the sign that was still there was a drawing of an apple and a drawing of a soda. So it was called right. Apple Soda. But it was a storefront. There was no lock on the door. And it was one of these things where whenever you were like, I don't know, I have nothing going on, I'm just going to go over to Apple Soda. And there was always people there, and it was always a party. And Midnight House was that when I first came to L.A.
Did you ever go to Michael Bush's second house, the other one?
A couple times, yeah, yeah.
That was like Midnight Show light.
It was similar, but it wasn't the same as the Midnight Show house. I remember one night we were at the Midnight Show house, and there's a huge party. And then across the street, there was this apartment complex. And these like Armenian gangsters started like beating a man to death in the driveway. And you guys had these hedges and I was watching, and I think it was me and Adomian and like Big John. Remember Big John? So we were all like watching and they're just beating this guy to death. And we were like, oh, and like Adomian could speak like some Armenian. So he's like, oh, this isn't good. Yeah, they're mad at him. Like, you know, like it was like, we're like, what the fuck? There was always fucked up shit going around at that house. Me and some of the guys from Midnight Show were there, and we were going to go enter the fucked up sketch competition. And people were doing insane stuff. I think like people would like eat pieces of shit and stuff.
Yeah. I've done that show many times. I've done things that I don't want to mention because it's like cancelable shit.
Like really cancelable or like?
Well, I don't know. It was
not like a salty kind of. Offensive kind of thing.
Yeah, super offensive.
I feel like you gotta like preface that because people, if you're like, oh, I could get canceled now, people are like, what are you like? What are you doing? Well, like, you know.
Yeah, no, like only like words and things.
Yeah, lame canceling. Canceling that is just it's just like joke. Okay, it was a joke and you don't like jokes.
Very. Yeah, but I feel like every comedian has shit that like, oh, you know, that one thing I did. Yeah, I'll probably never do that again.
Sure. Yeah.
Yeah. But in that show, like there was this one dude who got naked all the time. I saw that guy fuck a like his dick was out and he gutted a trout or a fucking bass and he fucked a fish. and then he also, this guy, Chris Stengel, who was good friends with, went to school with Neil Campbell and Paul Rust and those guys. And then another time this guy, this image haunts me for the rest of my life. He was smoking a cigarette on stage, and then he was naked, and he smoked the cigarette with his asshole.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, he like let his asshole smoked the cigarette. This is an asshole.
Yeah, I know. I got it.
And I'm trying to make it inhale.
So someone says, how is this a sketch? And that's a very good point. So once when the UCB, now for the people who don't know, UCB used to be a comedy school that I don't think exists anymore. But like,
It does. I teach there online.
Oh, you still teach there?
Yeah. But the giant Sunset location closed down. Listen, the pandemic's been hard on live comedy, that's for sure. So UCB, we'll see if they have live stages coming up, but still exists.
Okay, well,
hit hard.
Wow, you're like a real UCB, like what is it?
Shill.
Oh,
yeah. Listen, hey Trevor, while we're at it, listen, have you ever thought about doing comedy? Are you the funny one around the water cooler? Then go to UCB.
Go to UCB.
Trevor and scene. Okay, please continue.
Someone says, how is the reason Sunset got sold? Ask Joe Wagner. Now we're getting real inside baseball.
Oh!
This is, So the UCB, used to do these things, most offensive sketch show. And it used to be, like, comedy troupes would just start being like, what's our most offensive sketch? Oh, we've got a thing where it's like an abortion sketch or something like that. We'll pull out that. And that's what they would do. And so then as the years went by, it just started being people writing stuff specifically for the fucked up sketch competition. And then it really ceased to be people writing sketches. And then it was kind of just like, here's a thin like thing of like, oh, I'm a doctor. What's wrong with you? Oh, my asshole smokes cigarettes. Like that kind of like
the loosest framework possible. Just like with the faintest context that allowed you to ramp up into fucking a fish.
Yeah. And it was fun. And I remember hanging out at the Midnight House one night with a bunch of the Midnight Show people. And we were like, what if we smoked crack on stage? And we're like, we're going a different direction. We won't do like the scatological, but like, you know, crack has a very specific smell, you know, like we're like, if we start just smoking crack on stage, and I've never smoked crack, and like the other people hadn't smoked crack either, but we were like, that would probably win. So then it was, we had this idea at like noon. And so the show was at 8 o'clock, and it was us trying to figure out how to buy crack all afternoon. Like, we're like, do we just go to a park? Do we go, like, downtown? Like, Skid Row? That seems fucked up to just go and, like, you know, kind of. So then we were like, maybe we'll make crack. And we were, like, Googling how to make crack. We could find cocaine, like, you know. So we're, like, trying to figure out, but we couldn't do it in time. So, like, we didn't. But that's the mentality of that show.
Listen, Trevor, if you wanted some fucking crack, call the CIA. They're the biggest crack dealers in the fucking world.
That's the most fucked up sketch. The CIA.
Yes.
For shame. What they did to him? The first Irish president?
Oh, yeah. CIA. Killed Kennedy.
Killed Kennedy.
Also, killed Larry King.
Good. What if for some reason I hated Larry King? Rwanda. They've done all sorts of horrible things.
Oh, well, are they responsible for genocide in Rwanda?
Oh, they've done all of it. They, you know what I heard?
Dirty motherfuckers.
So I'm gonna show another one of your sketches.
Oh my goodness! All right.
I'm gonna show one of my. But let me go back to that for a second. So that kissing dog sketch is hilarious. And you showed it at your wedding.
Oh, so my wife and I both, so at our wedding reception, my wife and I wrote a comedy sketch that we performed.
You did a lot of comedy sketches.
And then my wife did like a comedic presentation about when she Googled me, all these weird characters and things came up and it made her take pause. And she brought up the kissing for dogs because she showed that to all of her friends and she was like, can I be dating this guy?
It was
I got the go ahead.
Yeah, it was shocking because, like, you know, I mean a lot of people that I know are comedy people. I've been to a lot of comedy weddings, but I've never been to a wedding where it was like, now we're gonna show like videos and now we're gonna do sketches. Like, you know, the groom has prepared a sketch.
I was very, that was the only thing I was nervous about that night. Will the sketch go over? Everything else was gravy. Like, I was so happy. My friends and family were there. But is the sketch going to bomb?
Well,
and it went over. I think my wedding sketch went over.
It did go over. But you, I was also, you had put me at the comedy table, which I thank you. You put me with people
I
knew.
You didn't want to be with my sullen cousins.
No, I would have liked to be at the Chernobyl guys table, though, honestly.
Oh, yeah.
But I was at the comedy table, and I was hanging out with a bunch of the people from Midnight Show and stuff like that.
Yeah.
And I remember getting there and sitting down and be like, what's going on? And they're like, I'm just nervous. And they're like, why? And they're like, well, Hal is making us do a sketch. And I was like, ha, funny. Like, I thought it was a joke. Like, you know. Like, Hal's making us do a sketch tonight. I'm like, that's funny. And I'm like eating like that. And then I could see them like looking at pieces of paper, like remembering their lines. And I'm like, what are you doing? They're like, I'm trying to remember my thing for a sketch. I'm like, wait, what? Hal's actually making you do a fucking sketch at his wedding? Like, and they're like, yeah. And I'm like, that's crazy. And they're like, yeah. And then like they got up and did it and it was great. It was good.
the sketch was like some kind of janky newlywed game or something. And it was the Midnight Show paired off into couples. And then me and my wife played ourselves. And so the Midnight Show did a bunch of weird bullshit. And we exchanged some real stupid anecdotes, my wife and I, about each other. And there it was.
Yeah.
Trevor, do you want me to show everyone what your wedding gift was?
Sure.
It's downstairs.
Did I give you something?
Yeah, you and Amy gave us something lovely.
Oh, well, it was 100% Amy. No disrespect. I that's not my department.
If you want, I could grab it.
What is it?
Or I could just say what it was.
What is it?
A lovely vase.
Oh, no, that was me. I was like, I told my wife, I was like, well, if I know Hal, he would like a vase.
Listen, full disclosure, the entire wedding... registry was my wife's work. I had no say in it.
Sure.
So, she thanks you for the vase, and I'm like, sure. The vase is great.
I'll pass it along to my wife.
Yeah, thank you. We love it.
All right, I'm going to show another sketch of yours. This is another one of my favorites.
Oh, boy.
Isn't this fun? You have no idea what it is. All right. This is another people. If you're just tuning in, Hal Rudnick. Fantastic, legendary sketch comedian. Also from Screen nice. Junkies. Also from the RoboCop remake with me. And here we go. Here is one of my favorites.
I'm going to go get the bass, okay?
In Beverly Hills, there is a getaway.
A getaway.
It is not for you or for me, but for the ones we love most.
The ones we love most.
Our pets.
Our pets.
Welcome to Pet Hotel! Cat in a scarf, right?
Pet Hotel.
Chihuahua get facial.
Pet Hotel.
Guinea pig eat a big boy sandwich.
Pet Hotel.
Lizard get a massage.
Pet Hotel.
Birdie in VIP lounge. Yay, 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 yay. Are you going on vacation? Leave your pet in a decadent hideaway, the sight of which would cause a homeless person to commit suicide.
A homeless person to commit suicide.
Let your beast bask in amenities, such as popular films remade with only animals. Dr. Strangelove with exotic fish. Alien vs. Predator with Birdie and Kitty. Made in Manhattan with pot-bellied pigs. Alfred Hitchcock's The Birds with birds playing both the people and the birds.
Both the people and the birds.
Never forget our animal cocaine, interspecies orgies, and our world-famous horse meatball pet spaghetti.
Pet spaghetti.
Cape Hotel, Beverly Hills, California, America, Earth, the galaxy, the universe, infinity, heaven, Pet Hotel!
Pet Hotel. Pet Hotel. Pet Hotel. Pet Hotel. Pet Hotel. Pet Hotel.
Oh, good timing.
Right back.
Yes. All right, Trevor, I brought the vase.
Oh, good. I want to see this thing.
Do you remember what it looks like?
No, not at all.
All right. Can we get a drum roll?
Oh, wow. Look at that. Wow. It's weird looking.
It is. It's kind of like a modern art sort of vase.
Yeah. Kind of looks like a big ceramic fleshlight.
I mean, let's find out. Is this coming through? Is it coming through?
It's coming through.
Thank you.
No problem. I will tell Amy. Like I'm so bad with that stuff. I always am like I'm the guy who's like Amy's like we have a wedding tomorrow. I'm like, who? You know, I'm just not good at remembering real life things or fake life things, honestly.
Yeah, no. I mean, I feel like I'm a little flighty when it comes to some of that stuff, and my wife is a lot better at making us presentable when we arrive somewhere.
Yeah, that's my wife's department. She does a pretty good job. She was great with herself. Like I end up being passable, kind of thing. Someone says, all right, let's look at some. I'm gonna actually do some donos, which I've never done on this show before.
What are donos?
So that's
the donors.
So by the way, Hal, Whitest Kids, is making a movie, a feature film.
That's exciting, dude.
Yeah, it'll be our second feature film.
After Civil War on Drugs.
Civil War on Drugs. So this one is animated, and I just saw the animatics yesterday. I got the animatics, and I got to watch like in it, and I'm very excited about it. I'm gonna start tampering my enthusiasm. Because I don't want to hype it up too much, but I'm very excited about it.
Sure.
And it's so all the money that we do on this channel goes towards the movie. Although since you were on tonight,
can I ask you what the style of animation reminds you of, or do you not want to divulge anything?
We said that we wanted it to be. We didn't want it to be too like you know how all that animation like is just kind of. We wanted it to be somewhat grounded and realistic,
okay.
But we still wanted them to have big eyes because we thought that was expressive. That's where we, you know, we showed them a bunch. We were like, not as realistic as King of the Hill, you know, but more. You know what we said? Have you seen F is for Family, Bill Burr's show?
Oh, yeah, a little bit of it, not a lot, yeah.
Yeah, we were like, that seems like the right amount, like where it's grounded, but it's still, they're still cartoon characters. They have big expressive eyes and stuff.
Gotcha. Cool.
Everyone's making fun of me for saying tampering.
Oh, tamping down.
Tamping down. That's what I wanted. I was a C student. I can't change that. All right, I'm going to read some donos here.
Nice.
I figured out how to do it. Okay. So, Daddius Maximus donated $50, says, John Hamm meets Mark, tell Sam that the John Hamm meets Mark Ruffalo in the garden section of Lowe's look is working. Well, that's got to be an old thing. Well, now I don't know how to fucking do it, because like, oh, happy Friday, Trevor. Twerkin donated $15, said, happy Friday, Trevor. Congrats on the momentous success of the flagship. You're the whitest kid we need, but probably not the whitest kid we deserve. That's very nice. And that might be the only donation. I don't know.
Oh,
I'm not sure if
donated. What are you waiting for?
I'm not.
Also, if you're interested in doing improv, there's no better place to study than the Upright Citizens Brigade.
I'm not sure if I just don't know how to read these.
You don't know the donos?
Yeah. Oh, here's one. Thanks for principal roles. Oh, we know principal roles. Thanks for putting the whole team on your shoulders while Zach is gone. All right. So there we go. And I'm not sure we might just not have a lot of donations. I didn't read them last week. So I think people are just like, he doesn't know how to do it. Well, now I do. So
yeah,
there you go.
So donate, and Trevor will read your shout outs. Maybe can they type something if they want you to say something really like stupid or weird?
Yeah, I'll say whatever. As long as it's not going to like be something I have to deal with, you know?
Gotcha.
Yeah. So, you know, write whatever. I'll read it. And so what we used to do on the old show, Zach and I used to do a show before this one, and we would read the news. So I think we could do that right now. Like we're an hour and 10 minutes in. We haven't touched the news yet, but let's get into the news a bit. Have you paid attention to the news at all?
Yeah, I listen to some NPR and I keep up.
Yeah, what happened?
Oh, well, people died. People were born.
Yeah, all right. Let me actually look to see what happened. Or chat, tell us, what happened in the news this week? I haven't been paying attention. So, let's go. Let's see. Okay, I'm just looking at the news. China plans Atlantic Naval Base so that they can... oh, you know what? I don't want to talk about that. I know what I want to talk about. So, Elon Musk is going to host Saturday Night Live tomorrow.
Yeah.
Now, so, are you a Saturday Night Live fan?
Am I a Saturday Night Live fan?
Yeah.
Hit and miss, you know. It's an institution that I, you know, it's a revered institution. And I think, they've done a lot of good stuff. Nowadays, it's, you know, some good, some forgettable. So, I enjoy, but you know what? Not every once in a while, I'll watch it live, but usually I just watch like whatever sketches are like viral or sent around the next day.
Right. I never watch it. I was an intern there.
Yeah.
I was Lauren's intern. I used to love it. And then I thought it got real, real bad for a very long time. And I stopped watching it. I haven't watched it for years. But then I've been seeing clips. I like this. I like the Bowen Yang.
Oh yeah,
yeah.
Bowen Yang is fun.
I've liked a lot of the stuff that I've been seeing of him. So like, and then I've heard people saying that it's getting good again. You know.
I really like. I got to. I know a bunch of those folks, and like you know, but it was really cool. I worked a lot with Chloe Fineman, who's on the show at UCB, and she's doing some super funny stuff.
Really? Yeah, so I'm kind of interested. I might watch the Elon Musk thing because he's hosting.
Well, what do you think about and it's a doubly controversial show because they have Elon Musk and Morgan Wallen. Morgan Wallen got in trouble for violating Corona protocols before he was going to be the musical act. And then also he got in trouble for there was video of him saying the N-word.
Wait, I thought it was Miley Cyrus.
Oh, who said Morgan? It is Miley Cyrus. Why the fuck? Someone must have posted that, and I believed it.
Who's this N-word guy you're talking about?
Morgan Wallen, this country guy.
Oh. You know,
I feel stupid because I heard it was Miley Cyrus, and I just saw someone's joke post.
Oh.
And I believed it. Man. Hey chat, roast me.
Elon Musk is hosting, and a lot of people are a lot of the cast are like, we won't do it, which I don't get. I don't understand. Like, because
no,
they did it when Trump was going to do it. They did it when Trump was going to do it.
See, that's the thing. I feel like they have the bad taste in their mouth from that. And now they're like, oh, this, you know, this billionaire who's like a little bit, you know, problematic and like the whole, you know, should there be a billionaire class, blah, blah, blah.
Oh, is that the thing? Because I feel like I've missed the Elon Musk, like, you know, I've heard Elon Musk rumors around town, But like,
having like three ways with Amber Heard or whatever.
Sure. Well, I think that's the reason that people put up with Amber Heard is like, you know, she's gonna find other girls. Like that's like, you know. But I,
That's what I heard.
Look, here's the thing. She's gonna shit in your bed. She's gonna shit in your bed, but she's gonna bring other girls. Like, you know.
Yeah. She'll leave a little. Listen. She'll leave a little log under the sheets. But she's gonna bring some. She's gonna bring her pansexual friends over, and.
But what is it that he's a billionaire? Is that why people are upset at him?
Well, also he was kind of outspoken about going against coronavirus protocols with his business practices, and yeah, and then he just does weird shit like making flamethrowers and selling them, and
well, that's cool. How is that not?
Yeah, it's
that's
kind of
rad.
Cool. He's part awesome and part dystopian villain, you know?
Right. Oh, someone, okay,
which,
I remember this.
Which for some people is all awesome, but.
Someone said he called a guy a pedo. Remember that?
Oh, yes.
So this is my recollection. I could be completely wrong. But a bunch of kids got stuck in a cave down in.
Yes, the soccer team in Thailand or whatever.
In Thailand. Now. He said, Musk, you know, he's a PR guy. He's trying to do PR. So he's like, oh, I'm a genius. I'll invent a submarine.
Yes.
You know, that'll go help these kids out. I'll make a kid-sized submarine. And so then he sent it down. And this one guy who was like an expat, like an American who lived down there in Thailand, yeah, was like, you know, yeah, we don't need your stupid submarine. Like, it doesn't work. He said something mean about Elon Musk. So then Elon Musk, who's the CEO of a bunch of companies and a billionaire, comes on and goes, this dude's a pedophile. Which is a ballsy thing to say. Now, part of me thinks that all expats who choose to live in Thailand are pedophiles. Like, I'm not going to lie. Like, you know, like I've said before in jest that the first thing I would do if I was president was set up a police thing in Thailand. And as soon as single guys got off the plane by themselves, they turn right around, they go right back on the fucking plane and they go to the slammer. So I get that.
Can I come clean tonight?
Sure.
I've been to Thailand.
By yourself?
No, it was with an entire movie crew. I was there.
See, that's fine. That's fine.
Yes, yes. But I'll tell you, I was, it's called, The Lost Medallion, The Legend of Billy Stone. And, look it up, enjoy it with your family. But while I was there, I saw a lot of, folks who looked like, expats, like 65, 70 year old guys. Walking around with their wives or girlfriends who are 20 or 30 year old Thai women.
Yeah.
So it's also popular to not exactly be a pedo, but to go like, hey, I'm a gross old dude, and this is a place where young women can marry me.
Yeah, I'm a gross old piece of shit, and these and these young women are so poor that like they're poorer than I'm disgusting.
Yes.
Like, it's the calculation they do. Like, you know, we're like,
poor, yep.
I'm this disgusting. Like, my little fucking, like, old man dick is this gross, but they're this poor. Like, you know, and so that's what all these guys do.
Pretty much.
Yeah.
That's like walking down the street. That's like what you're seeing all over the place. But you were saying, he called this guy a pedo.
I get it, you know. Like if some guy from Thailand who was like an expat who was single dude down there, and I'm not saying this guy is, by the way. I don't nothing from nothing. But if some guy said something to me, my first comeback would be like, well, you're a pedophile, you know. But I'm not the CEO of a giant corporation that has shareholders and like a lot riding on what I say. Yeah.
Those driverless cars.
Exactly. Right.
Do you hear one of his? Do you hear one of those driverless cars killed someone in Texas? Didn't one go rogue?
Yeah, but how many? I don't buy that. That never like bothers me because like people are like, oh, one of the Teslas killed somebody. But it's like, well, how many Fords killed people this week? Like, you know, like.
Oh, I mean, cars are they're murder machines.
Yeah, they should still be robots. Like, I 100% believe that if everything was a robot, we'd be better off, like car wise, kind of.
Ever heard of Skynet?
No, it sounds great. What is it?
Oh, no, it's your worst nightmare.
But have you seen the promos?
For SNL? With
Elon?
No, I haven't seen them.
Oh, let me look it up. Like, Sean O'Connor, who was my guest last week, he just tweeted it. And it's going to be a train wreck. Hold on, let me actually... This is going to be harder because I'm not actually, like, last time I was like, let me look something up, and I had the video already there, you know? I
mean, he seems like, yeah, he seems like he just has, like, no comedic ability. Like, I think it's going to be like when an athlete hosts, you know?
Like, yeah. Well, he's like a robot.
Yeah.
All right, hold on. I'm gonna share screen. I'm going to try to do it this way. But it's like, you ever see when... Wayne Gretzky hosted Saturday Night Live back in the 90s?
Not sure, but was it stilted and awkward?
Oh, it's amazing. I think they've scrubbed it from the internet. Like, and like, he's like, hi, I'm Wayne Gretzky. He doesn't know what to do. Like, you know, it's not his fault. He's a fucking, what he does is ice skates really well. And
yeah,
he like,
puts the biscuit in the basket.
Yeah. So I think this is going to be worse than that. But like, yeah, look at these promos that they made him shoot.
Yeah.
All right. Let me, I'm going to share screen. Well, actually I'm going to try, hold on. Let me see. There might be some,
Another terrible Saturday Night Live was, Nancy Kerrigan.
Oh yeah.
You remember, the ice skater who got, her knee whacked by Tonya Harding.
All right. So we're going to disappear. And I'm going to replace our video with this. But yeah, I think you'll still be able to hear us. So,
sure.
All right, here we go. This is what you have in store for you tomorrow night. Elon Musk hosting Saturday Night Live. All right. And hold on, I'm going to stop sharing. They're still doing, it also pisses me off when they're doing the masks things like that.
Oh, well, because
it's like, you know, you don't need it. You're in a studio. Everyone's been, I mean, like, it's good if you're in public with a lot of people, but I don't know. All right, check this out.
Maybe they're doing it to promote safety.
I guess.
Hi, I'm Elon Musk, and I'm hosting SNL this week with musical guest Miley Cyrus. And I'm a wild card to this. No telling what I might do.
Same here. Rules, no thanks.
But it's also the Mother's Day show, so your moms aren't going to be here.
Oh, forget what I said.
Fine, we'll be good-ish. Hi, I'm Elon Musk, and I'm hosting SNL this week with musical guest Miley Cyrus.
What's new with you, Elon?
I just did a successful rocket launch this week.
Hmm. Wow. Well, I did my laundry.
Congrats.
Actually, no, I didn't.
I mean, did it not play? Oh, no video?
Oh, no, I saw it.
Oh, wait. Oh, they couldn't, we can't see it. They couldn't see it. Shit.
What?
Hold on. I'm going to play it again. I'm going to play it again.
Trevor, I'm going to go pee-pee, okay?
Okay, sure.
I'll be right back. I just watched the video, so I'll be right back. We'll talk about it.
All right, guys, I got it this time. Trust me. I'm learning OBS. I thank you for your patience. Here we go. Share. Then I go over here to OBS. Zoom. Transition. Hit play.
Hi, I'm Elon Musk, and I'm hosting SNL this week with musical guest Miley Cyrus. And I'm a wild card to this. No telling what I might do.
Same here. Rules, no thanks.
But it's also the Mother's Day show, so your moms aren't going to be here.
Forget what I said.
Fine, we'll be good-ish. Hi, I'm Elon Musk, and I'm hosting SNL this week with musical guest Miley Cyrus.
What's new with you, Elon?
I just did a successful rocket launch this week.
Hmm. Wow. Well, I did my laundry.
Congrats.
Actually, no, I didn't.
All right, it's not working at all. All right. Didn't work at all. Hold on. All right, that didn't work. I apologize. But you gotta see it. It's really bad. How is chat doing? Oh, let me see. Let me see if I'll read some more donos right now.
Hit them with those donos.
Yeah. Okay. So we got a. Ermgard said, after watching those sketches, I feel like I must ask if Hal has fucked his dog.
I absolutely have not. That was, please separate the art from the artist. Get it together, Ermagod.
And then the real Jeff Bezos donated $20 and said, Trevor, you're doing amazing. That's nice. That's before I just screwed up that Elon Musk thing, so...
You're doing a hell of a job, Trev.
Jeff Bezos, people hate him too, because people hate billionaires now.
I mean, it does kind of suck that the conditions at so many of his Amazon outposts are really shitty, yet he has gotten like just exorbitantly richer during the pandemic, a time that fucking crushed so many people.
Yeah.
It's like, yeah.
Well, I'm all for, look, if everybody gets their shit together and wants to like rise up and like kill all these billionaires, yeah, I'll go along with it. You know, like I'll do whatever the majority wants. But like, there's also something like where, you know, I know. Now this is, so I have two thoughts in my head that they're kind of in contrast with each other.
Yeah. Very rarely is something black and white. There's a lot of gray area. Hit me with those thoughts.
I have two conflicting opinions. I believe that's called a
walking contradiction. I believe it's called
sociopathy. I don't know.
quite possibly.
But so part of me is like, so, because first of all, I hate most people that I see talking. And so, like, when someone's talking and saying, like, oh, Jeff Bezos, you know, and Jeff Bezos is like, oh, well, you need a billionaire. I'm like, no, you fucking don't. Like, you know, that whole, you know, like, you don't make a billion, you take a billion. Like, you know, kind of like, I get that. Cool. But then when I hear other people saying, like, you know that Jeff Bezos has more money than, like, 50% of Americans? Like, I'm like... Well, Jeff Bezos has helped our lives a little, you know, like in that coronavirus, like I was ordering everything off Amazon, you know, like 50% of, you know, 50% of the people haven't done shit for making my life better. So yeah, that's a very...
He was ahead of the curve. He created, like, we don't want to go to stores anymore. And he solved that problem.
Yeah. So... Remember when you had to go places? You never have to do it anymore. Like, we're so close to living like the movie WALL-E.
WALL-E,
which is what I want.
In chairs.
Yeah.
Oh.
Someone. Trevor, okay. So here we go. Someone says, okay. "Wow, fuck you, Trevor." Someone says, "Stop, Trevor." Oh yeah. So people are mad. Hey, look, I'm mad too. I bet
there's probably a. You know, a lot of Bernie bros and stuff in your chat, Trevor, and they don't like you, feathering the nest of the billionaire class.
No, I'm saying kill them. I'll go with you. Like, I'll help. Like, you know.
Will you, I'm going to ask you, will you go on record tonight saying that if the revolution happens and we storm the gates of the billionaires, will you plunge the pitchfork into... the chest of Bezos.
Absolutely. No, I will do... I will do whatever the majority is doing. Like, I am a survivor. Like, I will read the tea leaves. I will... You know, see... I will test the winds of change. And I will be right there with everybody.
I like that song, Winds of Change by the Scorpions.
Mm-hmm.
About the wall coming down. Trevor, I wanted to ask you... Speaking of Thailand, and it reminded me, so I know you used to, and maybe you still do, you were an early adopter, going on 4chan a lot, and
back
and
then, in the mid-2000s.
Yep. I don't know if you ever went on 8chan.
No. That
seems like a little too dark.
Well, no, I honestly think I was just too old. Like, you know, by the time 8chan was a thing, I was kind of like, I'm not really like doing that anymore kind of thing.
You know what? Maybe for the best. But the did you watch the QAnon documentary?
I did.
On HBO.
I did.
Yeah, what'd you think what'd you think of that Ron Watkins?
Well, I thought it was fascinating. Like, you know, like, so the guy, you know, he's like, you know, he might be a Q or whatever. And the whole reason he lives, does he live in Thailand? I forget.
Was it Thailand or the Philippines?
Yeah, but he
was Southeast Asia. It was Southeast Asia.
But the reason he lives there is so he can, because he grows pigs. Grows pigs. He raises. he raises pigs and slaughters them, and he didn't like the way that the laws were in the United States about slaughtering pigs. So he had to move. Like, you're like, no, I got a way. I have a certain way I want to kill these pigs. It's a little fucked up, but I will move over it. That's insane. Like.
Wow, I didn't realize that was the reason.
Yeah, I think so. That's what I took out of it.
I mean, horrid people, those guys.
Yeah.
Just the worst. And yeah, that doesn't surprise me. I mean, did he want to kill them in a less humane?
He probably just wanted to fucking shotgun them, like no scope them, like right in the fucking head, like, you know.
Boom.
Yeah.
Or just bleed them out slow.
The fucked up thing is, like, this is a cruel twist of the universe. Is that pigs are like the smartest animals.
Oh, yeah.
What do you think? I was a vegetarian for a long time. And
I remember that.
Yeah.
I was surprised when you went back to the meat.
Yeah, Dan Neubauer talked me out of it. I don't know. You know Dan Neubauer, comedian?
I
think about going back every now and then, because you know I didn't miss meat or anything.
I enjoy a nice vegetarian meal.
It's usually better than a regular. I usually prefer to have a vegetarian meal. It tastes better. It's fresher. Like all of that.
Hey. Being an East Sider, mm-hmm. Have you ever been to the restaurant over on Sunset, My Vegan Gold?
I love it. I love it. That's not even a good. That's not even a good vegan restaurant, but I love it. I eat there all the time.
Oh, I love that place.
I like Flore.
Oh, Flore's great. Have you had the orange chicken at My Vegan Gold, Trevor?
Mm-hmm.
Oh.
Very good.
It's like good fried chicken.
Yeah. I don't like eating all the fake meat stuff. You know, because then you're just eating a whole bunch of soy and stuff like that. I mean,
every once in a while, it's not going to kill you. This is some good fried. I mean, what's worse, the soy or the chicken that's been pumped up with steroids from fucking Monsanto or whoever?
It's a good point. It's a good point. So, but here's what I was going to say is the cruel twist of the universe is that pigs, kind of the smartest animals, you know, not the smartest. Everyone's like, oh, dolphins are so smart. They're kind of fucking stupid compared to us. Like, you know, like everyone tries to pretend that they're like, oh, it can you can show it a triangle and then you can show it another triangle and it'll know that that's a triangle or whatever. You know, they're not that smart, but still they're smarter than other animals. And, the pigs, maybe even smarter than dolphins, right? Super smart.
I mean, Charlotte's Web, Babe. What more do you need than those fictitious pig stories?
Yeah, but they're like the fucking tastiest animal that's ever been invented. Like, nothing tastes better than a fucking pig. So it's like, why would you make this? Why would the universe make this one of the smartest? It's like, what if we tasted fantastic? We don't. Luckily, we don't. You know, because
how do you know that, Trevor?
Because if a shark bites us, it goes away. It's like, oh, fuck, there's a human. Gross. You know, and it goes away because we don't have a lot of meat. We're like bony. So like, that's why usually people only get bit by a shark once. And then it goes, and it's like, I wanted a seal, but that guy was tricking me because he was in a seal suit because of the wetsuits. I don't know why we make wetsuits look like seals.
How's the surfing going?
I haven't been for a couple months. But it's going good.
Right on.
I still suck at it, but I love it.
Yeah.
But so it's like, we don't taste good.
Mm-hmm.
That's great. But like pigs.
The smell of bacon gives me half wood.
Oh. Pigs are fantastic.
I mean, just delicious little bastards, but also cute, like a little piglet, a pot-bellied pig.
My cousin has a pig. He has one, an indoor pig. It's
big,
like...
Big or petite?
Well, it's a huge pig.
Oh.
It's a big fucking pig.
I want one of those little petite ones.
Oh, like a little, one you put in your purse?
Belly.
Like a Paris Hilton pig? No,
yeah,
this is
I'd carry a purse with a pig in it.
No, this is a big, this is like a fucking man's pig. This is a big, pig.
Count me out. I can't deal with a man's pig.
So.
Too big for me. That's too much, pig for me.
So my cousin has this pig, and it lives inside with him. It lives in his house.
What's its name?
I don't know. I mean, this is back in Virginia, and
it's called Porky.
And this is a big fucking fat pig. Like, this is not what you would think is. Like, you would look at those little pigs and you'd be like, they're probably smart.
Can we not fat shame the pig?
Oh yeah, all right. I know you're not supposed to do that anymore.
Listen, this pig is a real fat fuck.
Big fucking fat pig.
Yeah.
And I was saying, and this is actually worse, now that you've said that, you've taken the knees out of what I was going to go, because I was going to say...
Oh, I'm sorry, my bad.
I was going to say that, like, you see these little teeny pigs, and you're like, well, that's probably a smart pig, you know? But you see a big fucking fat pig, you're like, that's not a smart pig, like, you know, So that's horrible, what I was about to say.
listen, maybe those big ones have a thyroid problem.
Yeah, so... So he's got one of these big fucking giant pigs, you know. You'd think it would be dumb as shit just because it just looks dumb. And it's so smart. And it loves my cousin so much. It doesn't like him to leave for work. So every night it finds his car keys and it hides it.
No.
Yes. And... Not like, oh, it's under the rug. They're in really fucked up, like, intricate hiding places, and they get harder because this pig is so smart. So it's like if you had a roommate, and my cousin's always pissed off about it because he's like, this fucking pig, like, keeps hiding my keys. I keep getting late for work. Like, you know, it's like if you had a roommate who didn't want you at work and, like, was smart and could hide your keys in, like, crazy places and stuff like that. So that's what having a pig's like. So anyway, very smart animals.
Damn. So like
it's a commercial for veganism. That's what that whole rant, and then it's
like pigs smart enough to hide your keys. Like that's very bright.
Yeah. And someone said, sorry I'm late, boss. My pig hid my keys. Bam Margera said that. Oh, Bam Margera, how are you?
Sorry about everything that's you're going through.
Yeah. But yeah, you're right. You can't like it. That sounds like bullshit. Your boss is only going to take that two or three times, then you're fucking fired.
Yeah, that's some dog eat my homework bullshit.
Yeah. Oh, the like, pig.
Well, your cousin needs to hide his keys from the pig.
He does. But the pig watches him like a hawk, or like a pig.
Like a pig hawk.
Like a pig hawk. So what else happened in the news? We got about 20 minutes left.
Sure.
Let's see. Oh, someone said, Bill Gates, Bill and Melinda Gates.
Oh yeah. Bill and Melinda Gates.
Yeah. The famous vaccine, charlatans. No, I believe in vaccines.
Shooting us up with microchips so we can get controlled by the 5G.
My parents, that's what they thought was happening. I had to convince them it wasn't.
Did they get vaxxed?
Yeah, but I had to basically say, you can't come and visit. So I basically used the grandson card, where I was like,
ooh.
I was like, you can't come and visit unless you got vaxxed, because they don't have, you can't vaccine a kid, you know?
Mm-hmm.
You know?
Oh, yeah.
Because we're old. Our bodies are like...
Yeah, I'm old. Use me as a fucking guinea pig.
Exactly. We can take your fucking microchips. Like, if I die...
Baby?
Yeah.
Yeah.
If I die, who cares? I've had a good run. Like, you know.
It's been a good run.
Yeah.
Trevor, which vaccine did you get?
Moderna.
Johnson & Johnson gang.
Oh, but that's the bad one, right?
Yeah, it's the bad one. My wife and I got the bad one.
But I've heard that, you know, if you make it through the 14 days without keeling over dead, it's actually the best for the new strains.
All right, good to know.
So actually, I think you're actually doing pretty good.
You know what? You just turned my frown upside down, my man.
There you go. But yeah, so Bill Gates.
Yeah, Bill and Melinda. I guess, you know, she got sick of being married to one of Jeffrey Epstein's best friends, right?
Oh, was he?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, wow.
I mean, he was on the travelogues. And also, there I read an article, I think it was from Daily Beast or something, where Bill Gates would take Melinda Gates to hang out with Jeffrey Epstein sometimes. And she was like, I hate this guy. But Bill Gates wouldn't stop being his friend.
Weird.
Bill Gates was friends with Jeffrey Epstein after Jeffrey Epstein was arrested on soliciting prostitution from...
That's fucked up.
Yeah, in like 2013. He was arrested in like 2008 or... I don't know.
See, like, I feel like you can be friends with fucked up people, but then once it, like... And you not know that what they're doing is fucked up. But then once it comes out, you gotta not be friends with them. You know? You can't be like, but he was like... He was... child trafficking a little, but like,
yeah,
you know.
I mean, kind of a deal breaker. Yeah. So who knows what's up with that?
So you think
I want to like Bill Gates? He seems like the nerdy genius that's philanthropic and trying to right all the wrongs of the world. But then, yeah, that's a little bit of a shit stain in the that's a little bit of a turd in the ice cream, you know.
But I heard Matt Groening was also. On that flight log.
Shut up.
I heard that. I don't know if it's true. Like,
wow.
I think Sam told me that, and I was like, no. Like, you know, but Jesus. that might have been before, like, they knew something was rotten in Denmark. But also the flight log. It wasn't the flight log just going to the fucking Kid Island.
Well, yeah. There was also like he went on a trip to Africa, like some sort of philanthropic mission with. Bill Clinton,
that's not good.
Chris Tucker, and Kevin Spacey.
That's not good. Like, I'm 100% convinced that Bill Clinton is a bad guy.
I mean...
if you've been a president of the United States, you're a fucking piece of shit. Like...
I mean...
No ifs, ands, and buts about it. Like...
Listen, if you wanted to, you could probably try every president ever on war crimes. You know?
Yeah. Presidents are horrible. It's the worst of us. Because to get there, to be that fucking insane, where like, even just to like, you know, if I like am driving and I daze off for a second and I hit a bump and then I like, you know, I'll drive. I'll be like, oh God, I hope that wasn't a person, even though it was a small bump, you know, like it couldn't have been a person. But what if a person was sleeping in the street and their head was there? And then I'll be driving and then I'll be like, ah, it's impossible. No way. No way. No way. And then like, 5 minutes later, I'll be like, fuck, I'm not going to be able to sleep unless I go back and check. Like, and I have to drive by the place and I look and I'm like, no, it's fine like that. So, you know, guilt, just fucking guilty conscience of like anything. Like if I, you know, inconvenience somebody, that's horrible. The idea that anyone could be like, I should be in charge of everyone. Like, anybody is insane. Anybody who's like, I think I should be president, we should lock them up immediately. We should probably just kill them. Like, you know, just like kind of like firing squad, you know, like that was a crazy person, you know. We should be drafting people, like the people who don't want to be president, like the story, like the nicest person you hear, like, you know, like get them, put them in tandem with like the smartest person, but the nice person gets like to veto the smart person. Like, that's what we should be doing. We shouldn't be letting like, hey, who wants to be the leader of the world? Oh, I'd like to try. No, they're fucking, no, that's horrible.
I mean, yeah, you got a lot of drones at your disposal.
Yeah.
What? And as we all know, drones be striking.
Someone says, Trevor, you're drunk. I'm not. I'm buzzed. Trevor. I'm buzzed. Bud Light.
Yep. Only the best swill for me.
Did you? How was your drinking during the Corona? Did it get a little high?
You know. There were a few high points, but my wife and I did discover a delightful drink. Oh, and I know you're a tequila enthusiast, right?
I am.
We started making kombucharitas.
What is that?
Kombucha.
Okay.
And tequila.
Oh.
And if you do you drink kombucha at all?
I don't. I feel like it tastes horrible.
I mean, there's a couple of good ones. There's like Pink Apple and Trilogy is a good kombucha. Chat, sound off with your kombuchas. What are your flavors? So, but I like Trilogy and, oh, kombucha's horrible. All right, Sparky Sin. Also, shout out to whoever took my sketch class before. Thanks for saying hi. But the kombucharita, my wife and I, Rebecca and I, swear by them. It's good stuff.
Really?
But yeah, our drinking spiked a little bit early on, and we evened out a little bit. But, you know, it's 5 o'clock somewhere.
Exactly. Well, there's no reason not to. That was the thing. Like,
who knew? Like, who knew what the hell was going to happen? It was like we were in the dystopian movie for a little while there. So
yeah.
It's like, yeah, what the fuck? Roll the dice.
I moved to the beach, and I was digging a hole for, like, you know, a long time.
Oh, yeah.
Just because I didn't know what to do.
How deep did that hole get?
Super deep, but then the ocean destroyed it. And then also, I think neighbors were complaining. They're like, someone's going to fall into that at night. Because at night, there's no, like, you know, there's no lights on the beach. So they're like, if someone's, like, walking around at night, they're going to fall and really hurt themselves. Because it got deep enough that you would hurt yourself if you fell into it.
Wow.
So they were like, you can't just be doing, like, you know, recreational construction.
You dug like a backhoe level trench.
Yeah, well, I hit the water table. Like, I hit the water table, and then I kept going, and like would just like get it out, and I basically got to rock. You know, like it was a deep hole.
Damn.
But yeah, I was asked by the community to stop.
You know what? I commend you for that project.
Yeah. But also, yeah, at a certain point, like, you're just like, well, how long is this going? And so you just start, like, every night is a weekend. I'll just drink.
How did you get in and out? If it was so...
Oh, because it was tapered the way to get in. Like, I went in, like, the way it was tapered. But so, yeah, so eventually, like, you know, I might have told this on stream before, but I, like, you know, I like to drink two nights a week. That's my sweet spot. I like to drink two nights a week. I do one on Friday. Sometimes I do Saturday. You know, if I do Saturday, I don't do a Tuesday. If I don't do Saturday, I do a Tuesday. And it had gotten up. It had gotten a little higher. It had gotten to about four, sometimes five, you know, during the height of Corona. And so I went to my doctor and, you know, I'm a hypochondriac and I was like, hey, I'm drinking a little more than I would like to. And my doctor just stared at me with this like dead, like military gaze. And he was like, everybody is. It was like just a really dark thing where I was like, oh man, this guy's like losing clients left and right. Like, you know, like, cause this is Los Angeles. Like it was really bad here. Like this guy has a lot of patients that he's known forever that are just dying. So,
wow.
Yeah. That's a bummer.
But the way you said it, it sounded like he meant like, you know what? Just keep doing it.
Yeah.
No one knows what's going to happen. People are dying.
Yeah. He was like,
this virus, it's going to get us.
He's like, I'd rather die with a drink in my hand than that shitty bat virus in my fucking lungs. That's what he said.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So long, cruel world.
Yeah. What else? So Bill Gates, he's single now.
Yeah. I mean, have you seen some of these guys getting called out for wanting, like the Ben Affleck video? That was pretty good.
Oh yeah, what did he do? He went on like.
So he was on Raya, which is the celebrity the exclusive dating app, and Ben Affleck he matched with this lovely woman and who was like probably 20 years younger than him or whatever, and she unmatched him because she thought it was fake.
Right.
And then he sent her a direct message on Twitter, which was like, hey, it's me. And then she shared that. And it's so now Ben is getting shit for it. But like, you know what? This is a town where a lot of guys date a lot of younger women, kind of like Thailand. So maybe, yeah. Except, so...
This is the
scale for that. Like the more famous you are, the younger the woman.
Well, I'll say in the United States of America, the last stop on the way to Thailand is Southern California. That's how you would go there. Like that's.
There it is.
Yeah.
There it is. And then another one came out today about Matthew Perry, Matthew Perry, who's like 50, who is 50.
His head's like this big at this point, right?
Yeah.
He's like got one of those giant. Pill heads.
Head, jowls, yeah.
Yeah.
He's been through a lot. But but he was 50 years old and,
hold on,
trying to chat up a 19-year-old.
Wait a minute. Hold on just a second. Somebody just alerted my attention to something where they're like, does Trevor know that the chat is hidden? I did not.
What? The chat's hidden?
Boom. There's the chat back.
Oh, this was before Matthew Perry got engaged. Before he got engaged, Dalek Ergfee. Sorry, it took me a minute there. Dalek Ergfee. Back when Matthew Perry was a single swinging dick on the town.
Yeah. So he wasn't 50. He wasn't 50 then, was he?
49 or 50.
Oh wow.
Yeah, he's 51 now. Here's a fun Hollywood fun fact, Trevor. I have two for you. Remember we were going to do gossip earlier?
Oh, yeah, let's do gossip.
Here's a little bit of hot goss.
Mm-hmm.
Guess who was, when they first moved to California, was Central Perk background on Friends?
Halford Rudnick?
Yes.
Oh, that's cool.
Doing background on a show like that, it's kind of the worst if you want to be in the industry because it's like kind of like the guy who came for the singing telegram. You are so close yet so far from anything.
Right.
When you're an extra on, on a show.
Has there ever been a story of an extra? Like, because whenever I've seen extras, and God love them. I mean, my God, a thankless job, low pay, long hours.
Yep.
But. There's always this look in their eyes where they're just kind of looking around, like looking how to can I, maybe if I impress this person with how I'm like carrying a binder, you know, they seem to have that. But like, has a celebrity had a story like that? Like I was a background person and someone saw me and they were like, you, now you're like.
I don't know if I have like a mega star story. I'm sure someone like had something good like happen to their career via that. But on Friends, the barista in Central Perk, Gunther, was, I believe, started as an extra.
Oh.
And he got bumped up to this like regular. And
that's cool.
That guy would always drink at Birds next to UCB, by the way, Gunther.
Birds is a big bar, and it's also where Aquaman got glassed in the face, and that's why he has that scar.
Jason Momoa?
Yeah. He was at Birds. And
got fucking glassed at Birds?
Yeah, and some dude, I think he was like talking to the guy's girlfriend or something, and some dude fucking glassed him in the eye with a fucking bottle, and that's how he has that scar.
Damn. And that is what caused his career to go into the stratosphere.
Exactly, because then he was like, he was, if you're a super hot guy, you know, you're inaccessible. But then he had got glass, so they were like, well, now he's accessible, and then he became a huge Aquaman.
Yep. Oh, one more story. So you broke the news earlier tonight, Trevor.
Yeah.
That Simpsons and Futurama creator Matt Groening
was at Pedophile Island.
Close personal friend of Jeffrey Epstein.
Yeah.
I was once interviewing Matt Groening for Screen Junkies, and I completely mispronounced his name to his face, and it was a very awkward moment.
What'd you say, Matt Groening?
I called him Matt Groening. Matt Groening, and his name is Matt Groening. So I pronounced both parts. I got it doubly wrong. It's Groening, and I said it's Groening, and I said Groening.
Did he say anything? What did he do?
Oh, he was a little bit miffed. He was like, oh, well, he was like, you know, I thought I'd done well enough at this point so my name would get pronounced right, but you know what? You never know.
Yeah. Huh. You made a simple mistake? Yeah.
You know what? It's a simple mistake. You know what? There are dipshits out there. They give microphones to anyone to stick in people's faces nowadays, and, you know, whatever.
Do you think Bill Gates will ever get married again? No, it'd be insane, right? How much is he going to have to give Melinda Gates? Like, Jeff Bezos, just everyone's getting married. Everyone's breaking up because COVID, everyone had to sit in their, like, so, you know, Jeff Bezos, he's usually around, like, he's probably, hold on, with Sam Brown, everybody.
Oh, Sam!
Hey, what's up? Not yet, but I know how to do donos. You know what I don't... You know what... Okay, I'll do them. But you know what I don't know how to do is raid.
Okay, well...
Can you handle that?
Yeah, I'll handle that.
Thanks, buddy. Talk to you in a bit. Sam is telling me to do donos, so I'm going to do donos in a second. But,
yeah, everybody was breaking up in the pandemic because you're stuck there, quarantined with, it's make or break.
Well, Jeff Bezos probably going around, like, you know, flying all around the country, like, fucking who knows what, like, you know.
Well,
like
he did get with that new newswoman, Lauren Sanchez, wasn't that his?
Yeah, some news lady.
The woman he broke up with. Yeah, but I think Bill Gates in his 60s, I don't know, do you think he's going to go on a, you know, just going to go on a fingering spree?
Yeah, I think... Yeah, he's been, I think what happened is they're all cheating on their wives. Like Bill and Melinda Gates pretend they're like, oh, we're just these wonderful people who hate malaria and all this stuff like that. And we just want to microchip you for whatever reason. But
I mean, one clue to me that Bill Gates might have cheated on his wife is that he was good friends with Jeffrey Epstein.
Right. So like Melinda Gates is at home. Like going through the encyclopedia, reading about malaria, while Bill Gates is out in fucking Thailand, being a fucking creep, and being with Jeff Epstein, and so then
maybe
the coronavirus happened, so everyone had to spend a year with their wives, and like,
oh boy.
And so then the wives were like, you look up a lot of Thailand stuff on your internet, like you know, and so. Basically, they're all getting divorced now, and Bill Gates. So supposedly, what happened was he was having an affair with his Chinese translator.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Interesting. Mm-hmm. Well, I heard there was no prenup between him and Melinda, and so she's going to be. Not have anything, she's not going to have any trouble paying for groceries.
Yeah. You know what? If I were Grimes, you know what I would do?
Yeah. How do you pronounce her baby's name, by the way?
Well, I don't know. I mean, like...
yeah.
As soon as...
You were Grimes.
If I were Grimes. All right. So I got Elon.
Yeah.
I got a kid with Elon. You know?
Oh, yeah. You're in deep.
Good. I'm good. Like, yeah. there's no, prenup's not gonna, whatever prenup he has, I'm fine. I got a kid with him. Like, that's,
oh yeah.
That's, I'm set. I break up, start super hitting on Gates and Bezos. Two more kids. Pop. Bezos kid, Gates kid.
I mean, and imagine hitting that billionaire trifecta.
She's two away. It's like those fucking Marvel movie rings. Yes. Yeah, those fucking Marvel.
The Infinity Stone.
Yeah. She's two kids away from being the richest person ever to exist. Like, you know, there was some like African king who they were like, he was like the richest person ever. I forget his name, but they were like, you know, he would go into a town and he would spend money and it would destroy the economy because there was so much like gold coming in. She could be bigger than that. She's got the Elon ring. She just needs to get the Bezos and the Gates ring. And then it would be like the richest person ever in history was Grimes.
The Thanos of billionaire fuckers.
Exactly.
Oh, that would be amazing. That would be quite a, like, you know, that I mean, they talk about like people who have like a good, like kind of like a really impressive dating history. Like that would be epic.
Yeah.
100% for that.
She'd be the first leader of the world. Grimes. Oh. Do you have a lot of Dogecoin?
No, I have. Yeah, I'm a little. I'm not in the crypto.
Oh, there's a new one. I'll tell you about that. I think is going to be big. It's going to be bigger than Doge. I think.
Really?
Yeah. I'll tell you. All right. Let me read some more of these donos real quick.
Oh yeah, do the donos.
Yeah, Sam said I should read these donos, and then we should raid Fantastic Plastics.
Right on. Can I plug something before we do?
Please do.
Great being here with Trevor. And before we raid and dono, just wanted to say follow my channel at Hal Rudnick here on Twitch. And if you ever listen to podcasts, I do a podcast with my pal about streaming shows every week called Binge Boys. Check out Binge Boys with me and Lon Harris, wherever you find your podcasts, all about what's going on streaming. And then we talk a lot of shit and make stupid jokes too. Thank you, Trevor.
Please check it out. Hal is good people.
Takes one to know one.
All right, I'm going to read these donos. Sam says I should read these. Let me see how to do it. I'm going over here. All right. This is from Benz, who donated $5, pronounced Bean-Z. That Elon Musk promo sounded cringy. Also, in OBS, add a display window and have the video in the other display, then hide it when you don't need it using the eyeball icon. Okay, I'll do that next week. Irmgard, again, said, Amazon helped everyone during the pandemic because the government shut everyone else the fuck down. That's a good point. So this would be an argument against the billionaires. Is that, you know, they're so in bed with the government. Like, you know, Bezos and Musk are both trying to get these, like, space contracts and stuff like that. That the government will just bend over and do whatever they want. So they have more power than presidents. So, anyway.
Yeah.
I've said it before. Yeah. If we're doing something about it, I'm with everybody.
You're a man of the people, Trevor.
I'm there. I'm just not going to be the first person. I'm not going to be like, we're doing this, because then no one will do it. But if everyone's doing it, I'm there.
Yeah, if it's like a foregone conclusion that like Bezos is going to fall, all right. No, listen, not I even, want my head on a pike too.
Not even a foregone conclusion. Even if it's fair odds, I'm going to throw my weight in with the good people.
Very early on.
Yeah. Tanzu for you. Donated $30, said a 24-ton rocket from China is going to crash somewhere on the Earth this weekend. No one knows where it's going to crash down, but apparently has a very large, or it could possibly land also in. So I think this is like when there's an ongoing joke where it becomes gibberish, and I think I just fell for it. Also, is the doctor in Bulgaria helping Zach with his baby penis? I don't know. I've got to check in with him. Yeah.
Oh, where's Zach? Is he in Eastern Europe?
He's in Bulgaria. He's directing a horror movie that he wrote.
Oh, amazing. That's so fucking awesome.
Pretty cool. Yeah.
So shout out to Orion Rain for posting in the comment section. Binge Boys, Binge Boys, Binge Boys, Binge Boys. Listen to Binge Boys wherever you find your podcast. It's some stupid fun shit. Thank you, Trevor. Any more donos?
Professor Marth Live donated and said, "Hey, Trevor, ever consider making a Just Roll With It for adults?" Yeah, that might be cool. I would do that. That'd be fun.
Can I come on and sell some weird trapdoor devices again?
Yeah, Hal is... you can watch Just Roll With It on Disney Plus right now. Hal's in multiple episodes. Hal was also a writer on the program. My God, I think we've done it. I think this was great. Chat, we can't thank you enough for hanging out with Hal and I tonight. We'll be here next week with a brand new guest. You've been watching the flagship. This is Flagship Fridays. I don't know if anybody is doing a raid, but if someone's doing a raid, because I'm not doing it, you could start it now.
Oh my goodness.
To Fantastic Plastics. And we'll see if anybody's in here. Otherwise, I'm
Trevor, I don't know what's going to happen right now with this raid, but I just want to say I had a heck of a good time chatting with you, buddy.
Me too. You too, dude. What's happening? Someone was in here. Someone heard my prayer. This is great. All right, we're going to raid Fantastic Plastics. Oh, I have the button. I can push it. Hal, this has been awesome. Actually, before we raid, I'm going to play a thing. Hal? Oh, we already raided.
Yes. Oh.
Did we already raid?
Oh, yeah. There's Sam and Emily.
Oh, those fuckers.
Hey!
Listen, I fucking own Twitch. I own it. I bought it. You can think you're going to raid whoever you think you're going to raid, and now everything's going to get directed to me, motherfuckers. I own Twitch. Simps head on.
So we're not on the air anymore, right?
No, dude. We're clear.
Oh, man. That was a good time.
Fun, right?
Yeah, totally.
Thanks for
having me.
Yeah, we had about 1,000 viewers for the whole thing.
Yeah, that was awesome. Yeah, I was going back and forth between the Zoom and the actual Twitch feed.
Yeah, I put the Zoom in a window, and then I can see the chat coming up on the side. We got to hang out nice. Soon.
Yeah, I'd love to, man. So everyone, I'm glad to hear that everyone had very mild corona.
We were good.
That's good to hear.
Amy had it the worst.
I was texting with you. Oh, go ahead.
Amy had it the worst, and it was just a bad headache for a week. But it wasn't. It never became respiratory for any of us.
Good.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's scary stuff.
I lost my sense of taste and smell for like 12 hours, and that was it.
Oh, you did?
That was it. You know,
okay.
Like,
yeah.
Augie, no symptoms whatsoever. But like, we had him tested, and he was positive. But like, he just, you know, little kids are like almost immune to this.
Yep. Yeah. That's what I hear. I didn't realize that his name was Augie. I always thought it was Augie, like August or Augustus.
It is, but the nickname we write Oggie just because I think that's fun.
Oh, that's
fun.
Really fun.
I think
really
it's fun, fun for a What's... kid to draw, like to write, like kind of thing.
Yeah. Oh, so is it? Is his full name Augustus?
August. Just August.
August.
Yeah.
Beautiful.
Yeah. Yeah. You should. You guys should come over some night.
We'd love to.
Yeah, hang out. He's like,
we're all vaxxed up. We got this Johnson & Johnson flowing through our veins.
Yeah, he's really fun now. Like, he's like, through the corona, like when corona started, he was like a baby, and now he's like a kid. Like, it's weird. Like,
what is he, four?
He's 3.5, but he's the size of a 5-year-old.
Oh, I remember you, like, yeah, he's going to be taller than dad, probably.
We think he's going to be like 6'8".
What are you, 6'4"?
6'6".
Damn, I undersold you.
Yeah. Hold on, Sam's calling me. I'll call him later. How do you hang up on somebody on an iPhone without... Oh, well. But yeah, you guys should like, come out. Hang out.
Absolutely. And I don't know if, Amy's parents are not too far, right?
They live in Arizona, but they have a house in LA and they have a beach house in, hold on.
Yeah.
Yo, what's up? No. What happens?